Hello, and welcome to my Peano Curve construction demo. The mathematician Giuseppe Peano was the first to publish, in 1890, a paper that showed how to construct a space-filling curve. In a nutshell, a so-called Peano curve is a continuous, super-squiggly line that passes through every point in a square. My construction here, for simplicity, substitutes a triangle for the original square. But the process, in broad terms, is essentially the same. As you can see, my construction of the curve begins with a simple bent red line segment traversing a triangle, which I will call the master triangle. In the steps that follow, that segment will be repeatedly stretched and bent to make it pass ever nearer, if not actually through, any given point in the triangle. The final result, after an infinite number of repetitions, is the curve that Peano sought. Note that the simple red line path through the master triangle begins at the upper left corner, or vertex, with a solid line, and ends at the upper right vertex with a dashed line. In the succeeding steps, the starting and ending points into and out of the master triangle will always be the same. Now watch the progress of the red line path in the first subdivision of the master triangle. The master triangle has now been subdivided into four subtriangles. The red line path again starts at the upper left vertex of the master triangle and winds its way through each subtriangle in the order of blue, gray, green, and orange shadings. As before, it terminates at the upper right vertex of the master triangle. Again, the direction that the path takes through any subtriangle begins with a solid line segment and ends with a dashed line segment. The next animation reconstructs the red line path through the next subdivision. Each of the four subtriangles in the prior step has now been divided into four smaller triangles, giving a total of 16 subtriangles. Similarly, the four bent line segments of the prior red pathway have been replaced with 16 bent line segments. Note that the blue, gray, green, and orange pathway order has been maintained. Now, let's take a closer look. Here, the four-triangle subdivision of the master triangle is displayed in the left-hand diagram, and the 16-triangle subdivision on the right. Note that each of the subtriangles on the left, labeled A, B, C, and D, is subdivided into four triangles on the right, with corresponding labels. The black dashed line central triangle should help clarify the subdivision boundaries. The guiding idea in doing a subdivision is to treat each triangle as a miniature master triangle. In fact, the A and D subdivisions on the right are exact replicas of the diagram on the left, but reduced to a quarter of this size. The B and C subdivisions, however, are less tidy looking because the B and C triangles on the left have been rotated and flipped prior to being subdivided. But this complication is only a visual anomaly of the construction and, as such, has no effect on the final result. In this regard, it is interesting to note that Peano's paper had no diagrams at all, but relied solely on an abstract mathematical argument. To save time, here are snapshots of the next two subdivisions, showing 64 and 256 subtriangles of the master triangle. In principle, successive subdivisions of the master triangle could be continued indefinitely, but at some point my computer would run out of memory and the program would crash. Of course, the math behind the construction is not concerned with computer shortcomings, so that, in the limit, as we say, the final red line path will fill the triangle. Thanks for watching this demo, and I hope this sheds some light on Peano curves.